Okay, so it's opening morning of Moose in the Regina WMZ. Me, my brother, and my dad all got drawn. And my brother just had his first encounter about an hour after sunlight, so that's a good sign. Came in on the wrong side of him, winded him, and took off. But he said it got real close even though the wind is on his side. There's just deer tracks. Hunting with permission only. The signage here sucks. Most of the signs, if there are signs, don't even have signs, or they're old signs that are almost ripped off and gone, or everything like that. More deer tracks. So, alright, I'll let you know if we see anything.
Moose tracks and shit, fresh tracks and poop everywhere. There's been a lot of moose through here. I just have to find them. So far, it looks like I'm the only human who's been in here. A lot of birds in this bush.
In the woods, may not have had very many opportunities. I haven't even seen a moose yet, but we just found a big shed. Hold it up, Mac. Look at the size of that shed. That's a good one. Holy shit. Well, we're gonna keep hunting. That's a good sign.
5 minutes into the bush, second day of moose hunting, and this stupid little rough grouse did not know I was a predator. Don't know how much meat is going to be left on him, but looks like I just got the one breast, so the other breast should be good. These blunt tips really go through everything I shoot at. Really cool place. Really cool place. think he went down. Actually, I think I can see him sticking his head up, I think. Or I don't know. I don't know. I can't tell. But, oh, God. This is unbelievable. This is my first bow kill ever. My first bow kill ever. And it's a bull moose. From 25 yards. Using the Cabela's copperheads. Cabela's Stalker Extreme arrows with the Luminox red. Shot. That's all I asked for. All I asked for. I'm gonna sit here for 20 minutes. Give him a chance to die. So, I'll turn it back on when I'm going up to him. So to give you a rundown of the events, I got to this bush, it's a big bush, and I got to the watering hole, probably only 300 yards away from here, and I sat there calling for about 45 minutes, and nothing came in, so I decided to get up and stealthily walk down these trails, and there was a few crossroads, and I chose the right trail, I guess, and when I was walking, I saw a black thing, and I looked over, and it had paddles, and he was laying down. And from when I saw him, I was 40 yards away, to now, I got the shot off at 25, and it took a long time, because there's so much debris in here that I couldn't get a clear shot, and I didn't want a deflection. So I stocked up until, well, when I got to this, but I had just enough. I had about a foot and a half clearing of where I could shoot a bedded shot. I aimed for kind of his neck area. It was hard to tell when he was laying down. It's kind of dark in here, so, but first shot hit the neck, didn't go deep. He stood broadside and shot him again with a follow-up shot. The follow-up shot was perfect. Perfect shot. And, well, I'm hoping he's... I think he went down. It looked like he went down just over the... I don't even know if it's a hill or what, but... Yeah, and it's going to be a long haul to get him out of here, but... It's a better spot than most, so... Alright, I think I'm going to go check out the... Oh, fuck, yeah. Oh, Jesus Christ. He's nice. He's nice. Couldn't ask for a better bull. Honestly. Really couldn't ask for a better bull. I got some work ahead of me. We're not going to be able to drag him out. We're going to have to quarter him. So, time for the tough part.